In the last class, we studied the initial basics of transportation models. And in this class, we are now going to understand the methods generally used for solution of transportation models. The transportation algorithm is the algorithm used to solve a transportation problem. So this algorithm may be summarized into the following steps. Number one, first we formulate the problem and arrange the data in matrix form. What does it mean? That we make a table in which origins and destinations. Origins means supply sources from where goods or consignments are to be transported, and destinations are the points where these consignments are to be received. In the table, we also mention the cost of transportation of one unit of material from one source I to say another destination J. After doing this, we make or we try to obtain an initial basic feasible solution. Generally, three methods are used for finding out the initial basic feasible solution. These common methods are northwest corner rule, NWCR, least cost or matrix minima method, and third is Vogel's approximation method or unit cost penalty method. And this is in fact the most popular method for solving the problem of transportation, but we shall study each and every method which have been enumerated here. But two conditions must be satisfied, that supply and demand constraints must be met. Means you cannot supply more than what is available, and you cannot accept more than what is required. So no source can supply more than what is available there, and no destination can receive more than what is required there. So this is one condition. And so what does it mean? That supply and demand, total supply and total demand must be equal. Second is number of allocations, number of sales where supplies have been made should be equal to m plus n minus 1, where m is the number of rows and n is the number of columns. Rows means source and columns means the destinations. So number of rows and number of columns, if this is m and n, then the number of allocations or number of points where supplies have been made should always be equal to m plus n minus 1. Then only this method is transportation algorithm can be used. After obtaining the initial basic feasible solution, we move towards the optimality. Because this is the initial solution, that may not be the optimal solution. So we move towards optimality. For this, the stepping stone method and modified distribution method or UB method is used, which you shall discuss in the subsequent classes. In this class, we are trying to concentrate on the getting initial basic feasible solution. And step 4 is that either stepping stone method or the MODI method, what is known as modified distribution method, is used until the condition of optimality is reached. So we first start finding out initial basic feasible solution. So the first method or the easiest method is northwest corner rule. This rule says that start with upper left corner cell of the transportation matrix and allocate minimum of the rim values corresponding to the first row and first column. Let me explain to you in this example. Suppose these are the origins and these are the destinations. So what is the, so normally in a, on a graph paper or on a map, this is the north, this is the south, this side is east, this side is west. So north west means this corner, left hand corner, the first cell entry in the northwest corner. This is here, this cell, this cell. So what do you see here? This D1 destination. So we have to say make the first allocation in the cell described by O1 D1. This cell is known as O1 D1. This can be denoted by this cell O1 D1. So demand at the destination 1 is 6 and supply is 14. So minimum of these two is 6. So because you cannot supply more than what is demanded, or you cannot supply more than what is available, so minimum of 2, 6 and 14 means 6 units are supplied here. 6 units are supplied here. So this is what is said in the northwest corner rule, that the first step is that start with upper left corner cell of the transportation matrix, upper left corner, this is the upper left corner, upper left corner. So start here and allocate commodity equal to the minimum of the rim values. So minimum of the demand and supply. So that is 6 here. If allocation made in step 1 is equal to the demand of the first destination, then move horizontally to the next cell, 1, 2 in the first row and second column. Repeat step 1 for next allocation. What does it mean? Suppose 6 we have supplied 6 units here, so this demand of this destination is already met. So say we strike out this column, so this column no longer exists. Then consider that we have only 3 columns, D2 column, D3 column, D4 column, and availability of the origin O1 now gets reduced to 14 minus 6, because 6 has already been, this is the supply available, so 6 has already been supplied here. So 14 minus 6 means this supply amount will be available, will be 8. So we again start from here. So what we do? So from, instead of cell 1, say I considered it 1, 1, and now we go to cell 1, 2. Here we give the, so demand has been met. So we make another supply of 8 units minimum of these two. This is the, here demand is 10 and supply is say 8, because 6 units have already been exhausted. So now we are left with 8 units. So we make a supply of 8 units. What happens? Now this origin is exhausted because there is no supply available at this origin. So we delete this row. So now we are left with what? Two rows, only O2 rows and O3 rows, and only three columns, D2, D3, D4 columns. In this column also, now the requirement of D2 will be reduced to 2 because 8 units have already been supplied here. So now you have O2 and O3 rows and D2, D3, D4 column. The requirement at this point is now 2. So what is the now northwest? This is this. Here the requirement is your only 2 units. Availability is 16 units. So what will you do? You supply 2 units here. Then this requirement is met. So delete this column. Now you are left with only 2 columns, D3 and D4. D3 and D4. And 2 rows only, O2 and O3. And this requirement 16 has been reduced to 14 because 2 is already supplied to D2. Now you have only cells O2, D3, O2, D4, O3, D2, D3 and O3, D4. So what happens? Here it is 14 units available, 5 units here and 15 units here, 4 units here. So now this is the left most corner or northwest corner. So here the requirement is 15, supply is 14. So we give here 14 units. So this 14 units is total available quantity here, and this has been exhausted. So you delete this row. Now you have left with only one row, this O3. And two columns, one column, this D3 column and D4 column. So now here, what happens? 14 units were available, so 14 units is exhausted, or demand of D3 is reduced by 14 units, so only one unit is left here. Demand of only one unit is there, and 4 units demand is here. So now, because there is no option, so one unit will go to this O3 D3, and 4 units will go to O3 D4, and this will be the initial basic possible solution. So what we have seen, now we explain to you the steps. If allocation made in step 1 is equal to the demand of the first destination, then move horizontally to the next cell in the first row and second column. If allocation made in step 1 is equal to the supply available, they move vertically to the next cell in the second row and first column. And this step is repeated until we reach the stage where the total supply is made and we reach the southeast corner cell. So I have explained to you this. This is the easiest method. Here we do not give any consideration to the cost of transportation. Only the allocation has been made here. So what is the final, say, allocation? 6 units here, 8 units here, 2 units here, 14 units here, and 1 unit here, 4 units here. So see, O3 as a supply of 5 units, all 1 and 4, 5 units are exhausted. This has a supply of 14 units, so 6 and 8, 14. This has a stock of 16 units, so 2 and 14, 16. Requirement D1 has for 6 units, so 6 units already met. Here D2 has a requirement of 10 units, 8 and 2, 10. And D3 has a requirement of 15 units, so 14 and 1, 15 units. D4 has a requirement of 4 units, so 4 units. So all the requirements have been met, all the supplies have been exhausted. This is the method of northwest corner rule. And now you can find out the cost of transportation. So this cost of transportation will be, see, where are the locations? Locations are at O1, D1, O1, D2. These two are empty cells, these are occupied cells. Wherever allocations have been made, these are cells are known as the occupied cells. Otherwise, this is other where no allocation has been made. So these cells will be called as empty cells. So how many occupied cells you have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. 3 rows, m is equal to 3. 4 columns, 1, 2, 3, 4. So m plus n minus 1, 7 minus 1, 3 plus 4 minus 1, 7 minus 1 is equal to 6. So exactly 6 allocations have been made. So transportation algorithm, the condition of this index is satisfied. So this problem can be solved further for its optimality. Otherwise, if it is less than or more than m plus n minus 1, then the problem can no longer be solved. And you have to remove degeneracy before you attempt to solve the problem. So now let us examine what is the cost of transportation here. So this says 6 units have been supplied from O1 to D1, and the cost of transportation per unit is, say, 6 rupees, so 6 into 6, similarly 4 into 8, in the next rule 6 into 6, 4 into 8, plus 9 into 2 and 2 into 14, 9 into 2 into 2 into 14, then 6 into 1 plus 2 into 4, 6 into 1 plus 2 into 4, that is 128 rupees. So we have seen that by applying the northwest corner rule, the cost, initial cost of transportation is 128 rupees. Now we move to the next method, that is called least cost or matrix minima method. This method is far superior to the northwest corner method in the sense that it takes into account the least unit cost of transportation to obtain the initial basic feasible solution. So the algorithm used is explained here. We first identify the sales with the least cost, lowest unit cost in the whole transportation table is identified, and we try to allocate there as much possible, as much in as much quantity as it is possible as per the deemed conditions, and then we line out or remove the corresponding row or column where the requirement or the demand is met. And this way we proceed until the entire allocations are met. So let me explain to you the same problem here. Or this is a different problem. This is a different problem. So here, the cost of transportation from, say, origin 1 to A is 14, 1 to B is 15, and 1 to C is 10, and demand of A is 28, demand of B is 22, demand of C is 6, and requirement of A is 12, 20, 24, 12. So what is the total requirement? 20 plus 24 is equal to 44 plus 12 is equal to 56. And the availability is also 28 plus 22, 50 plus 6, 56. So supply and demands are the same. Therefore, rim conditions are satisfied. Now, out of this entire table, which one or which cell has the lowest cost? So see, it has 14 values in the cells, have the entries like this: 14, 15, 10, 19, 13, 21, 17, 26, 9. So 9 is the lowest cost. 9 is the lowest cost. So what means? You can say this 3C has the lowest cost. 9 units of transportation from source 3 to destination C. So C has a requirement of 6 and 3 has a stock of 12. So minimum of these two, because I have repeatedly told you that you cannot supply more than what is required and you cannot supply more than what is available. So you give the minimum of these two, 6 and 12. So 6 units you are supplying, going to supply here. Now this requirement is already met, requirement at destination C is met. So you delete this column. So column C is gone. And the availability of at origin 3 will be reduced to 12 minus 6, because 6 units is already exhausted. So 12 minus 6 is equal to 6. So 6 units is left and this column is deleted. Now we have only two columns, column A and B, and three rows, 1, 2, and 3. Availability is 20, 24, and 12 minus 6, only 6. So now, what is the least cost again? Now it is C. The costs are 14, 15, 21, 13, 17, and 26. So 13 is the lowest cost. What happens here again? The requirement is 22, availability is 24. So we find out the minimum of this 22 and 24, that is 22. So we supply 22 here. So this requirement is also met. Then the availability at the source 2 will be reduced to 24 minus 22 is equal to 2. So here 6 units, here 2 units, and this column is also deleted, because this requirements at destination B has already been met. So now you are left with only one column and three rows. Here the requirement is 20 and availability is 28. Sorry, requirement is 28 and availability at source 1 is 20. Here, from origin 2, the availability is 24 minus 22 means 2, and requirement is 28 units for destination A. So what do we do? Now we have no option, because here 20 units, we have to supply here. 2 units is left, so 2 units will go here. And here 6 units, so 6 units will go here. It is not 8, this is 6. So 20 plus 2 plus 6, 28 units. So in the lowest cost method, we have seen that we first choose the lowest cost in the entire matrix and allocate the maximum possible quantity, and then delete the relevant row or column, and then reschedule by again assigning, allocating the maximum quantity at the point where the cost is minimum. And this way we proceed until we are able to allocate the entire quantity. So, applying this method only, we have allocated, we have various quantities in this table, and the cost of transportation will be equal to 14 into 20 plus 21 into 2 plus 17 into 8 plus 13 into 22. And you also see one thing, there are three rows, A, 1, 2, 3 rows, and three columns, 1, 2, 3. So M plus N is equal to 3 plus 3 is equal to 6. So there should be five number of allocations, five numbers of occupied cells where some allocations have been made. So m plus n minus 1, you count here 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So exactly allocations have been made at 5 places. So the conditions of degeneracy is also met. That is, number of allocations is exactly equal to m plus n minus 1. So this problem has a feasible solution. And the cost of transportation will be this 14 into 20, see here. 20 into 24, 21 into 2 plus 17 into 8, 21 into 2 plus 17 into 8, similarly 13 into 22 plus 9 into 6, 13 into 26 plus 9 into 6, that comes to 798 rupees. This is the method adopted for solution of, for getting the initial basic feasible solution by, say, least cost or matrix minimum method. But the most suitable method is Vogel's approximation method, commonly known as VAM, or unit cost penalty method, or regret method. But these names are not common. VAM is very common name. And until and unless you are asked to solve the problem by a particular method, you always use VAM in the examination, because this is quite possible that VAM will give you the optimal solution at the first stage itself. So you will save a lot of time in solution of transportation problem if you apply VAM. Otherwise also, if you do not get the optimal solution, hardly it will take one or two steps more to get the final solution. So always use VAM, and VAM is very easy to use. I will explain to you the various steps required to solve the problem by VAM. This is a heuristic method. Heuristic method means this is a well-researched method and generally preferred over all other methods, because it gives the initial basic feasible solution, which is either very close to optimal solution or it is the optimal solution itself. The main feature of this is that it considers the highest unit cost penalty, means difference between the smallest and the next smallest transportation cost, and we make the first allocation where this penalty is maximum, and then we proceed to allocate at all other points in the similar way. So I will explain to you with these steps. Step one is calculate the penalties for each row and column, for each row and column separately, by taking the difference between the lowest and the next lowest unit transportation cost in the same row or column. In case if two cells contain the same lowest cost, then the difference is taken as zero. Obviously, because if two costs are similar, then it will be zero. Select the row or column with the largest penalty and allocate as much as possible in that cell where the least cost is there in the selected row or column, and which satisfies the rim conditions. If there is a tie, use the following method to break this tie. If, what is the rule? If difference is maximum, ties, select least cost cell. If maximum unit allocation, tie select arbitrarily. And after adjusting the supply and demand of that line, that row or column is deleted. Remember that only one either row or column will be deleted. If row and column both are deleted simultaneously, it means the problem has become degenerate. And then we have to adopt some other method that we shall discuss in other class. So only one, either row will be deleted or column will be deleted. And this step 1, 2, 3 will be repeated until the rim conditions are satisfied. So now I explain you with this example. So say these are the factories F1, F2, F3. And these are the warehouses W1, W2, W3 and W4. Factory 1 has a supply of 11 units, factory 2, 13, factory 3, 19 units. Warehouse W1 has a demand of 6, W2 has a demand of 10, W3 has a demand of 12, and W4 has a demand of 15. What is the total demand? 6 plus 10, 16, plus 12, 8, 28, plus 15, 43. What is the supply available? 11 plus 13, 24, plus 19, 43. So supply and demand are equal. So this is a balanced transportation problem. And now we use the Vogel's approximation method to solve this problem. So first, what we do? Find the penalty. Highest penalty of each row and each column. How do we do it? So find the difference between the least cost and next to the least cost. So in each row and column. So in this row, say row 1, there are 3 rows. I say F1 row, F2 row, F3 row. So in this row, what is the least cost? Least cost is 13. What is the next least cost? 15. What is the difference? Difference here, delta 1, this is 15 and 13, that is 2. So in the first, say, row, the difference between the least and the next to least cost is 2. Secondly, in the second row, we have 17, 18, 14 and 23. So 14 and 17, these are, 14 is the least cost and 17 is the next to the least cost. So what is the difference? 3. 3 here. What is the difference between least and next to least cost in the third row? This is 32, 27, 18 and 41. So 18 and 27, least value is 18 and next to least is 27. So 9. So 9. We write here in the first column, 17 and 21, this is 4. Second column is 16 and 18, it is 2. And in third column, 14 and 15, it is 1. Fourth column, it is 13 and next value is 23, this is 10. So, where is the maximum penalty? What does it mean? Why we get the difference of the least and next to least cost? That if you are not able to, this says that if you are not able to allocate at the least cost and you go to the next least cost, the penalty is of 10 units. So where you get the maximum penalty, we will try to first allocate maximum quantity there. So what happens here? So your maximum penalty is corresponding to column W4, warehouse 4. So we first allocate here in this column. What will happen? In this column, we'll allocate. Where will you allocate? Where the cost is minimum, not at any point, 14, 13, 23. At the cost is lowest here at 13, so you allocate here. How much can you allocate? The requirement is 11 and, the supply capacity is 11 units and the requirement is 15 units. So we'll be able to supply maximum 11 units here. So you are supplying 11 units. So the entire stock of factory one is exhausted. So what you will do? You will simply cross this line. Means this line no longer exists because the supply of factory F1 has exhausted. So you delete this line. Simply draw a line through pencil. This will exhaust. Now again you calculate the difference. Now you are left with only two rows, F2 rows and F3 rows. Two and columns still three, W1, W2, W3 and W4 also. W4 also. So column 4. So now this row is not here. So here, what is the difference? 17, 18, 14, and 23. So 14 and 17, the difference in the second line, second difference, delta 2 means second difference is 3 here. Now, the difference between 17 and 32 is 15. 18 and 27, difference is 9. 14 and 18, difference is 4. And 23 and 41, difference is 18. So maximum difference is again here, 18. So we make second allocation again in this row. So what will happen? You have now requirement of 4 units only, because out of 15 units required here, 11 units have already been supplied, so only 4 units are left. So you supply a four units. So 4 units we have allocated here. Then what happens? The requirement of this warehouse is met. So you now delete this column, delete this column. So now you are left with 3 columns, W1, W2 and W3 column, and 2 rows, F2 and F3, because F1 row is already gone. So this row is gone and this column is gone. And because you have supplied 4 units here, so this requirement has, this supply capacity of F2 has reduced from 13 to 9, so 9 and 19, and this is gone. Now you have 17 and 32, difference is 15, 18 and 27, difference is 9, 14 and 18, difference is 4. This row, 14 and 17, difference is 3, third row, third difference, delta 3, and 18 and 27, it is 9. Maximum difference is here, 15. So we again allocate the maximum quantity possible in this warehouse. So the requirement is 6. So we, and availability is 13 minus 4, 9. So we give 6 units here. So this column is, requirement of this column is gone. Now you have only these two rows and these two columns also. And this, we have already supplied 6 units. So this is gone. So now 13 minus 4, 9 units were left. And again, 6 units have been supplied. So you have 9 minus 6, 3. 3 units is available here. And 19 units here. So again, find the difference. So 18 and 27 is 9, 14 and 18 is 4. And here 16 and 14. 18 and 14, the difference is 4. And 27 and 18, difference is 9. So, here you have a tie, because this difference is, maximum difference is 9 here, 9 here. The corresponding to this 9, the cost is, minimum cost is where? Here 18. Corresponding to this 9, this cost is 18. Here also. So here also you have a tie. So you can arbitrarily choose anywhere. So suppose you decide to say 3 units which was left here. So you 3 units you give here. So this line is gone. Now 3 units has gone. So only 7 units is left here. And 7 units have been supplied here. So 19 minus 7, 12. So 12 will be allocated in this F3W3 cell. So the final solution, the final supply is this. 6 units here, 3 units here, 7 units here, 12 units here, 11 units here, and 4 units here. The cost of supply will be equal to how much? See here. From first row, if you go row wise, 13 into 11, then 17 into 6, plus 18 into 3, plus 23 into 4, plus 27 into 7, plus 18 into 12, that is equal to 796 rupees. And this is the cost of allocation by using VAM. So you have learned how to use VAM. This is very useful technique. We shall solve some more problems subsequently, and we shall learn to use the optimality conditions also after finding out the initial basic feasible solution. So these things we learn in the next class. I close the class here today. Thank you.